Welcome back to yet another exciting figure review. Tonight we're taking a look at the MonsterVerse, Godzilla and Kong, the new Empire, Suko with Doug by Playmates. And these are really cool. I'm super happy to have these because I know that you Americans were having troubles finding these because they're supposed to be super rare, but I'm happy that I was able to find these at my local Toys R Us. They were on sale too, so I saved 20 bucks. But here is Suko and Doug. You can see Suko with Titanus Doug. You can see the two figures there with like the crystals. The electrical effects looks really cool. You can see Godzilla evolved, King Kong. You can see the cool like sort of monarch futuristic logo stuff looking like they're being studied or something. You have a nice image here of Godzilla evolved and King Kong again. Godzilla and Kong, the new empire. And then on the other side, you have the same sort of crystals that we see on every packaging with Suko and Titanus Doug. And then on the back, you have the two figures. Obviously, you can see the whole line here. Godzilla with Atomic Breath, Godzilla Evolved, Shimo with Frostbite Blast, Kong with Beast Glove, and Scar King with Whip Slash. It's fully articulated, and you can see the two figures. Something that's really exciting to me here is that Doug as a character is awesome. This little Hollow Earth lizard that we saw in Godzilla vs. Kong, and people loved him so much they started calling him Doug, and now he's officially a character, and he's actually being called Doug, like, officially, and not just as, like, a joke. That's just so awesome. Godzilla and Kong return in an all-new adventure, pitting the almighty Kong and the fearsome Godzilla against a colossal, undiscovered threat hidden within our world, challenging their very existence and our own. Then you have Suko here with Titanus Doug. Don't let his size fool you. Suko is a scrappy fighter with raw primal strength and a bad attitude who always has Kong's back. So obviously setting up that father and son duo that these two are going to have in the movie. But yeah, this is getting me super excited for that movie. Literally comes out this week. We got our Doug and Suko figures. Without further ado, let's get them unboxed. All right, here is Titanus Doug and Titanus Suko, and they look really cool. So I guess we'll start off with Doug, the kind of meme character, a character that everybody made into a joke and now is a real character. So here is Titanus Doug. I could have sworn he was more of like a grayish brown, similar to Godzilla, but oh well, at least we have it. So he's really cool. See his eyes there. Pretty basic paint on this, but it's not bad. The sculpt is really good. All these like misaligned scoots all over his back. He's got like some armored plating here on the legs. Tail is articulated so you can rotate it all the way around. It's on a ball joint up and down all around. It can do all those great things. His head can rotate, but it's like really stiff on mine. His legs can move back and forth as you'd expect. So not a lot of articulation on this Doug here, but he does have a little bit going for him. Really love him. He got all the muscle details on his chest here. Does have these like kind of stubby little legs with like claws on the end. Nice kind of crocodilian tail. Very thin though compared to the rest of his body, but really cool. So there is Titanus Doug. Moving in, we have Suko, which looks really cartoony in this figure. I like the kind of change they did from like having it like this gray skin to fading into brown. That looks like a nice transition. Really cool. This kind of chocolate brown color for his fur, even though he had more of like a ginger fur in the commercials. Lots of articulation on this guy. Like, he does have a fully rotating head. Move his arms all the way around. and they can move out. Does have elbow articulation there. No, oh, he does have a swivel. Nice, I thought they're not going to give him a swivel, but they did. Again, the same on this side. Move it around, up and down. Does have the swivels here on his arm. Oh, wait, the arm itself is on a swivel too? I thought it just went back and forth. That is... Dude, they're pulling all the stops with this guy. Same on the other side here. And then he does have a full rotation here at the waist. He does have back and forth movement. He can move... His leg can basically move 360 degrees. That is... They put all the shit into this guy. Why? He must be a great character. You got the ankle swivels here too. Okay, this is cool. They put all of the stuff into the suko, which leads me to believe that he's going to be a major character. I thought he was just going to be like this kind of side character, equivalent to like Grogu or like Olaf or one of those cute characters that's basically designed to market the film and to sell toys, which, I mean, he most definitely is, but he probably has a major role in the film if they've taken this much time to like really flesh out the figure. Like, this is the most articulated figure I think in the whole set of these Playmates Godzilla and Kong the New Empire figures. He does have a rock, the best figure ever. Like, I love doing figure reviews on the Majesty. A very small rock. Look at that, the way it's all misshapen and cracked, the surface area so beautiful. Yeah, there's not much really to the rock. It's just a rock. Suko can kind of hold it, but he has to like be like holding it like it's an egg or something. It's not the best. In the commercial, I think we see him using the rock to like bash Scar King in the face with, but it's not very effective because Scar King's like huge compared to Suko. But there they are. I can imagine like maybe they're gonna like throw the rock and then the dude's gonna get it, bring it back to him like some sort of dog or pet. I can definitely see that sort of dynamic going for Suko and Doug here, is that Doug is gonna be like this kind of pet to Suko, kind of friend that he plays with. Really cool. For comparison, here is Suko and Doug next to Kong with Beast Glove, and you can see how they compare. Pretty small figures compared to the other ones in the line, but nonetheless pretty cool. Here are Godzilla and Kong the New Empire Suko and Doug by Playmates, next to the Godzilla and Kong the New Empire Scar King with Whipslash, next to Suko and Doug, also by Playmates. Next up, here is the Godzilla and Kong the New Empire Suko and Doug by Playmates, next to the Godzilla and Kong the New Empire Battle Roar Godzilla Evolved. Barely fits into the frame because they're so tiny. Next up, and lastly for size comparison, here is the Godzilla and Kong the New Empire Suko and Doug figures by Playmates, next to the Godzilla and Kong the New Empire Godzilla Evolved with Atomic Breath Funko Pop. And they look really cool next to one another. These guys are perhaps the cutest figures that we've reviewed out of this line of Playmates Godzilla and Kong the New Empire figures, but obviously Godzilla and Kong are the main stars of the movie, so they have the best figures, but I feel like this one has its merits, as you literally get two figures, and you get Doug. You get the meme character that everybody loves and made jokes about, the kind of pug of the Hollow Earth, the pug to Suko's baby toddlerness. But with all that being said, I definitely think that Suko is the best articulated-wise. They did so much with Suko and his articulation, not to mention they included the freaking boulder that he uses to hit one of the Kongs, and presumably Scar King, at the end of the movie with, and you get the little Doug dude, the meme character, the guy that everybody loves from Godzilla vs. Kong. But with that being said, let me know what you guys think about these two in the comments below, and with that, do take care, have a great night, and I'll see you in the next video.